Founder Director, City Montessori School, Dr. Bharati Gandhi, presented the vote of thanks and hoped this healthy competition between the schools will be a small step towards world unity and peace.
The students all had joy on their faces and confidence in their eyes. I also thank the children of CMS, of Station Road Branch, and honorable parents who have given us such wonderful children to train. If the parents are good, if the tree is good, the fruit will be good.
International Computer Olympiad, COFAS 2012, is a kaleidoscope of computer-related applications and activities where students compete with each other on a whole range of competitions like the debate, computer quiz, e-collage, mathcom, soft tech, brains, etc. School is a heaven on earth, and at City Montessori School, this philosophy guides the CMS education to lay lot of emphasis on human and spiritual education, to teach our children to have commitment towards the whole of humanity.
Before God, whom I love and worship, to be a worthy student of my school and abide by its rules, to love and respect my parents and teachers, and to follow their guidance, to consider all the people of the world as my brothers and sisters, for we are all the creations of one God. To work for the cause of world peace and happiness of all the people of the world. To develop my mind in sciences and arts, and to let my religion guide me in my actions.
Founder Manager of City Montessori School, Dr. Jagdish Gandhi, who 53 years ago started CMS as a laboratory that is intent in producing children around the belief that school is a lighthouse of society, providing meaningful education, spiritual direction, guidance and leadership to not only its students but also to the parents and society at large. The social responsibility of a modern school is to unite the disunited world and make every child a gift of God to mankind, a pride of the human race and a potential light of the world by imparting all three kinds of education, that is, material, human and divine.
And once you are enlightened, and through prayers and through communion, and you develop a serene mind, you can bring out anything from a mind. Everything that we see all around have come from the mind of man. When God created this earth, He made two kind of species. One was man, another was animal. He gave five things equal to man and animal. Food, man also requires, and animal requires. Shelter, animal requires, and man also requires. Fear, man fears the death, animal also fears the death. Sex, man and animal both do sex. Free will, man and animal both have been given the free will by God. You can be a good man or you can be a bad man. You can become a savior or you can become a killer. Likewise, a snake can bite a saint or a scoundrel. He doesn't know what is saint and what is a scoundrel. A lion can kill a saint or can kill a bad man. He cannot make out. So it is the free will have been given to man and animal equally. So five things are equal to man and animal. There is only one thing which God has not given to animals and God has given to man, and that is the rational mind. Animal doesn't have a rational mind. They cannot rationalize what is right or what is wrong. They cannot make out a choice. What is the correct choice? What is the incorrect choice? They cannot choose. They cannot make out what is right, what is wrong. They cannot do justice. They do not know what is justice. They cannot take a decision, right decision or wrong decision. They cannot make a judgment. But man has been given the rational mind. With this rational mind, your rational mind, if it goes upward towards God, you rationalize into the teachings of God. But if your mind goes against the God and goes toward the world, your mind can be destroyed. You can destroy your mind. You may become destructive. You can become a rapist, a murderer, a killer. You can do anything. Because the mind is not connected to God, then it will be connected to the world. So many scoundrels you see, so many rapists you see, so many murderers you see, so many terrorists you see. The mind is not connected to God. So through the rational mind, because we are rational people, we can visualize what is right, what is wrong. We can understand to be godly is good, to be ungodly is bad, because we have a rational mind. So utilize the rational mind. So true education, religious capacities, develops analytical abilities, confidence in oneself, willpower, and goal-setting competencies, and it is the vision that will enable him to become a self-motivated agent of social transformation. Education must prepare a child, a contributing member to the society, so that he can bring about a change. To education, religious capacities, which are hidden in the nature of a man. There are reservoir of capacities. Whatever the mind of man can conceive and believe, it can achieve it. You can achieve a thing the like of which has never been seen by the eye of existence. Whatever you can conceive, any idea, or believe in it, you can achieve it. So conceive. Connect your mind to God through prayer and communion, and then enlighten your mind, and then conceive to do godly things. Whatever God wants, He has sent His teachings for our benefit, for our help, for our growth, for our happiness, for our joy, for our exaltation. All the holy books have been sent by one God, as required, from age to age, to open the mental locks of mankind and to cure the maladies of the age. Every age has its own malady, and for every age, God has been kind enough to send His message from the kingdom of God to a purest soul of the earth, who was the purest of the earth, and sent His message. And through Him, this message was spread all around the world. And these manifestations of God, These divine educators who came to the earth, they gave the message of God to the people, and after giving the message, they left their bodies here and returned, their soul returned to the same God, where from their soul came, and where from the message of God came. They returned to the same God. So there is only one God. There is only one Allah. There is only one Rabb. You can call him by any name. There are thousands and thousands of languages in the world. Maybe millions of languages. In every language, the name of God is different. But he is one. He is a soul. He is a Ruh. God is only one. For every human being, there is only one God. There is only one Allah. And he is Rabbul Alameen. He is not the God of individual, any caste or creed or color, or for any particular people. He is the Rabb of Alameen. He is the Rabb of the whole world. He is the God of the whole humanity. We are all children of one God. And his religion, religion means duty. His duty is to love the whole humanity. He doesn't love for a particular caste or creed or color. His message is not for a particular people. From age to age, the message comes. Not all the messages come at one time. They have come from age to age. The revelation of God is progressive. Progressive revelation means religious truth is revealed by God progressively and cyclically over a time through a series of divine teachers, and that their teachings are tailored to suit the needs of different ages and places of their appearance. All the revealed books of God are unerring. There is no mistake in it. Whether it is Bhagavad Gita, whether it is Holy Quran, whether it is Bible or Guru Granth Sahib or Tripitak or Kitab-e-Aqdas or Kitab-e-Ajavishta, all the holy books of God are unerring. There is no mistake in it. And they are the collected wisdom. Since the day God created this earth and the sun and the moon, since that day, till the book was released by God himself through a farishta sent by God from the kingdom of God, through a messenger, this book was released, the teachings were released. Entire wisdom of the entire world, since then, since the beginning to the time of the book came, all that wisdom is confined into that book.
A lamp lighting ceremony was performed to mark the beginning of the competition rounds of COFAS 2012. The chief guest, Justice Vishnu Sahai, thanked Dr. Gandhi, said, "Throughout its over 5 decades of distinguished service in the field of education, City Montessori School has been actively working to construct the defenses of peace in the minds of students. No wonder City Montessori School is the only school recipient ever awarded with the UNESCO Peace Prize in 2002.
Mr. Gandhi, I thought, was a very wise man. But I am having second thoughts. Why? The reason for this is, for a festival which is held in connection with computer, he has invited someone as the chief guest who is blissfully ignorant about computer. I really do not know. I think it's more the affection of Mr. Gandhi, or it's more his heart prevailing over his head. It is the heart prevailing over science. You see, I hope my friend Mr. Jaydeep Mathur would not mind if I divulge a secret, you know, while we were waiting for the program to start. He also said the same thing. And I should not be venturing as to why Mr. Gandhi has invited me. I think again this is a case, you know, of heart prevailing over the head. Otherwise, there's no other reason. Vela, you see, as a judge, I used to issue mandamus. And after retirement, when I started coming to the CMS, it was an account of a mandamus being issued to me by Mr. Gandhi. My mandamus was often challenged in Supreme Court. I have never challenged Mr. Gandhi's mandamus. And the reason is, he is doing such a tremendous job, you know, not only for the cause of education on an international scale, but also for striving to bring peace and harmony in this strife-stricken world. I admire the patience of the man. He just doesn't give up. And probably what he thinks is, as a shair once put it, and that is what prompts Mr. Gandhi to do what he is doing. The shair said, "Ek ummeed pe jeena tauheen hai jeene wale ki, is ilm yaki ki duniya mein jeene ke sahare aur bhi hain." Baral, Mr. Gandhi, your patience is absolutely marvelous. And may God grant you long years, good health, and I can assure you that despite the fact that consistency is the virtue of an ass, I would rather prefer to be an ass and comply with your mandamus whenever you invite me in future.
The day's competitions began with debate on the theme "Online Education is Just as Effective as Classroom Education." The debate was conducted by Ms. Surabhi Sahai, Research Scholar, English Department, University of Lucknow. 50 teams of students from India and abroad participated in this competition, displaying their debating and intellectual skills. Each team was represented by one speaker who had to speak for 3 minutes for or against the motion as decided by a draw conducted.
Let us consider a situation. You have to appear in an exam tomorrow, and while going through the notes, you come across a concept you can't recall. Now, you have two options. Firstly, you call your friend, discuss over it, and about an unfruitful discussion, you both are tense throughout the night, can't prepare the subject, and you ruin your exam the next day. Well, that was one case where you preferred your online, your classroom notes and your batchmate. Now let's rewind. If you opted for online education, then when you got stuck, you visited the site where you studied about it, saw the video of the teacher explaining the concept. Voila, you have refreshed your memories and you are now as enthusiastic as you were the first time. So what's your preference? Online education or classroom education? If you still choose online classroom education, then I think it's not your fault. It's the fault of the society that has made it mandatory for us to join the schools. Now, let me tell you some more things which might change your mindset. Most of us don't like to get up early in the morning to go to school. No such need in case of online education. You get up anytime, switch on your laptop, and go on with your studies. Where you might be sitting, whatever you might be wearing, it doesn't matter. So no more wasting time in getting ready and commuting kilometers to reach the school. Moreover, you don't have to accept any Dick and Harry as your batchmate. You can choose them. You can correspond to that person who are according to your mental level. So no nuisance created around you while you are studying. Some other benefits of this online education is that we have wider range of knowledge. We can dive deep into the subject and gather as much information as we want. And when you're tired, you can pause the video and resume it when you're ready. So you can play, pause, rewind, and fast forward your teacher. So learn according to your pace when you're mentally prepared. This property of human nature is known as learner's pace. One of the biggest merit of the online education is that we can compete and interact with a larger number of people. Thus, in the end, I would like to say that as there was Gurukul era, Pathshala era, and classroom education era, how would the online education era would etch itself in the history of mankind depends on us. The choice is ours. Thank you.
The participant took 2 minutes and 46 seconds.
All right, Suyash, so is Harry present today? The Harry who don't want to be present, is he present? He's not. So I hope you're happy. Okay. I didn't know waking up was such a big issue till I came here for this debate. Questions? Ones who haven't asked? Yes, the lady.
According to you, isn't discipline important? I mean, if you said that we can do things whenever we want to, right? Yeah. So this Kufa's debate wouldn't be happening at any time you wanted to at your leisure. It was scheduled to be held at 10:30 and it was held at 10:30 only, right?
It was not, it was at 11:30.
Whatever the case may be, I mean, that's not a point of discussion, right? The point of discussion is that do you expect your online education teachers to instill this discipline in you? And secondly, also that you said that you can do things at your convenience. This was not at your convenience. So?
Actually, discipline is not the matter here.
It is.
No.
All right, no conversation. Have you answered the question or do you have to answer the question?
Discipline is not the matter here. Our personality is developed by our education. The discipline is never important to me.
All right, ones who haven't asked for long. Okay, I think I did not give you a chance last time.
The whole and soul of education is that education and learning are two different things. How can you say discipline is not a part?
They are same thing and discipline is not the part. You have to be such talented that the other person might wait for you. The other person must be that much talented. You must be more talented than the other person.
Right.
We have seen personalities like Shah Rukh Khan. They are always late at their sets. Why? They are such famous personalities.
The thing is,
all right. I think the question is over. He has answered it. Shah Rukh Khan should be answer enough now. All right. We move on to the. Thank you so much.
Classroom education imparts skills that are essential while dealing with sundry situations. Wisdom appears brighter when there is someone to inspire with a strong motivational force. Overcoming our infirmities and making us a man of integrity with strong moral values. I have taken both online courses and real life ones, like most of us on this thread. And what I analyzed was that classroom education is much far better than online education.
Online education does not provide that in a comparable fashion. Online education is not as effective as class education. Part of attending school is about learning norms and traditions of our own culture, not to mention learning from the differences of other students that you will encounter in school. This is greatly lessened in online education and will result in a less socially developed student. One major part of being successful in life is socialization. The absence of in-person student interaction and student-to-teacher interaction makes the differences between types of schooling quite significant. Online education eliminates the competition spirit between students. There are no instance answering in online education. There are no group work or lab work. These sections make a huge part of building the student's scientific experience. Students who wish to learn something may have much to gain through the internet, but only using online education can be deterrents. Students need teachers telling them what to do in real time. They need people to demonstrate what to do. They need fellow students to interact with in person. School is a way for people to get out and experience the world. And being shut in a tight space in front of your computer all the time means you never have the true bond with your teachers and fellow classmates than you had before. Online education depends on a lot of variables that could be weak. For example, if the student was in the middle of a lecture or exam and some problems happened with the electricity or the internet or the device itself, that could deprive the student from completing his studies. Part of going to school is developing and fixing the student's character and behaviors and adding more self-confidence and to try to remove the bad attitudes of the student by giving the student leadership courses and giving the students enough time and attention to make his character ready for the real life. Online education does not provide character development and enhancement or leadership courses that could destroy the student personality. Thank you.
The batsman took 2 minutes and 56 seconds.
All right. Thank you so much, Hamza. Questions? All right, one here, one there, and then next turn. Oh, we just have one question from this time onwards. Complete the question in one line.
As you are talking about absence of competitiveness among students when it comes to online education, do you know about things happening in Chennai, St. Petersburg, and Boston where students study together but online in a classroom type ambience? So there's no absence of competitiveness there. Like, that point goes big. Don't you think so?
Okay. In online education, it's called online. It's depending on internet LAN, internet connection. When you are using online connection, it might have some problems with it. It might have a delay on it. If you are participating on an instance answering exam and have a delay in it in the forum or the class online, you don't have enough time to deal with it.
While the debate was on, students of the school section were busy writing the preliminary round of the quiz. Collage competition was significant, in which students made beautiful collages on computer and expressed their capability in art and understanding of the computers. This competition was held for both junior and senior sections separately, in which they used clippings of matter to project their concept, art, and skill. MathCom contest for the senior section was based on computer-related mathematics, which tested students' mathematical skills and logical applications. In the Brains contest, which was based on mathematical intelligence, 46 teams comprising 2 participants participated. This event was aimed at testing the mental ability, analytical skills, and logical capability of students as they had to solve 20 questions in 1 hour.